Hello and welcome, Wellness Warriors, to this week's Tip Tuesday. Now on today's episode, I'm going to talk to you about managing your sugar habits, okay? So if you have a sweet tooth, you know how difficult it is to resist sugar. I don't have a sweet tooth, so I don't struggle with that, but you might be, especially when you have a craving for it. It is so hard. Anything you crave, it's really hard. Because you guys, you know what? Sugar is one of the most addictive foods out there. And quitting sugar isn't easy, as you might think, just like smoking. Cigarettes for some are very hard to quit. However, with a little bit of willpower and planning, it is possible to tame that sweet tooth, okay? But again, willpower and planning. So, we probably know each other, but if we are meeting for the very first time, I am Dr. Wanda Parks, and I help women over the age of 40 with metabolic and autoimmune conditions better their health at the cellular level. I help you reduce toxins, inflammation, and pain in as little as 30 days. So, let's talk about this sugar habit. I want to give you some tips that will help you kick your sugar habit if that's you and something you struggle with, okay? So, number one, the best way to do this is to get rid of temptation, because anything that tempts us, we're going to probably go for it, all right? Stop buying those sweet treats to stock up your pantries and your cabinets, okay? If it's not in your house, guess what? You'll be less likely to eat it, right? So anything that's easy to grab, we're gonna go for it. You wanna satisfy your sweet tooth with some healthier alternatives, all right? Such as some fruit, okay? Because fruit contains natural sugars. Also, for diabetics, you might wanna be careful with the type of fruits, but everything in moderation, okay? Berries are low in sugar and they are full of beneficial antioxidants. Cinnamon is also a fantastic spice that makes your food taste sweeter without a lot of sugar. And it even helps regulate your blood sugar levels. So that's one you might wanna run and have in your cupboards, all right? Number two, you wanna watch out for hidden sugars in any of your foods, okay? Sugars aren't only in the obvious culprits such as pop or chocolate bars, some people may call it soda, but they're in a lot of other things that you may have, like your condiments, such as your barbecue sauces, your ketchup, as well as your packaged breads, okay? So you wanna be mindful. These items might be fueling your sugar habit and you don't even know it. So you need to remember that even foods that are labeled as healthy can have tons of sugar in them. So you have to read your labels. Whether it's white sugar, cane sugar, or brown sugar is sugar. So the key is read your ingredients and you need to be aware of what's in your foods, all right? So the other thing is, you want to start your day off right with healthy, nutrient-dense breakfast. So you say, I don't like to eat breakfast, but that's going to cause you to have a spike too. So you want to make sure that your breakfast is full of healthy fats and protein. Whenever you eat breakfast, you want to start off with that. Protein and fats, they digest a lot slower than your carbohydrates and your simple sugars. So they will keep you satisfied a lot longer. You guys know a healthy, balanced breakfast also stabilizes your blood sugar levels. Sugar cravings are often the results of a sudden drop in blood sugar levels. And that's why it's crucial that you shouldn't skip a meal, especially not the first day of the meal, because you start having that roller coaster and what you're gonna do is pick up something quick. I want to tell you guys, go over and check out the video I did on 80/20. And then also you can join my free workshop on kicking the sugar habit, and the link will be in the description box below this video. Number four, I want you to drink enough water, because sometimes you confuse being thirsty for sugar cravings, and you may start, you're not drinking enough water throughout the day. So you need to do that. I also do some challenges with water, so you can jump in on that. If you find yourself craving for sugars and you have a glass of water, wait a few minutes and see how you feel. That's being aware, because you could just be a little dehydrated, all right? So you wanna check, you know, be aware of that. If you are enjoying these tips, I would ask that you subscribe and share my video. I really appreciate that. So let's move on to number five. You want to plan your meals ahead of time and your snacks. Prepackaged foods contain so much sugar, but that's usually what we gravitate towards when we're hungry or in a rush and you need something to eat real fast. Instead of doing that, why don't you prepare something healthy before you go ahead of time? So before you head out the door, so I have a meal planning workshop coming up. Register for that. What you can do is wash and cut up some fruits and vegetables, prepare you some trail mix with some nuts, some dried berries, but be careful of sugar so you have something that you can grab and go, all right? And you have it all packaged up. So again, like I said, I have a free workshop on meal planning. If you struggle in this area, that will also be in the description box below. So you can jump on and register for that as well. Number six, I want you to take note of when and why you're getting the sugar craving. Be mindful. Is it a particular time of the day, or is it when you're feeling stressed out, or are you feeling sad? If you notice a pattern, then I want you to think of some other ways to help you cope with that. For example, go for a walk to de-stress. Make a cup of tea. Go for a run. Give yourself a replacement comfort food that doesn't have sugar, okay? You want to replace that, because becoming aware of your eating habits can do wonders for you and all the future cravings. So you want to be aware of that. Lastly, number seven, okay, this is the last one. You got to go all in. You have to give yourself grace. You don't have to ditch sugar altogether, okay? And I'm going to say, I know I just gave you all these tips to help you, but you don't have to do anything cold turkey, because it will more than likely keep you stuck and you create resistance, and then you don't make change at all. And then what happens, you're going to fall back into your old habits because you didn't do behavioral changes. So get on a call with me. So start by addressing these minor tweaks as I mentioned here today. If you find yourself that you're still needing some help and you're still struggling and you just don't want to go cold turkey, because that is very hard to do, you want to start to love how, if you start switching these things out, you're going to feel better. If you find yourself struggling with kicking these habits, like I said, or you can't get rid of that mid-waist bulge, then I really want you to get on a call with me. It's a discovery call. It's the Get Well discovery call. So you just getwellwithwanda.com. Also register for the free workshops below. And let's have a conversation on how I can help you get rid of the mid-bulge, get off the roller coaster of up and down sugar cravings. Because if you don't do it, you know you're procrastinating. As I always say, procrastination never met a goal. So head on over and check out some of my other videos. And I'll see you next week. Bye for now.